Survival expert and author James Wesley Rawles returns to his Patriots series with his latest novel, Expatriates. I'm Dimcat, and this is my review. Hey guys, welcome back. Expatriates, gonna be released October 1st, 2013. My review, you know, this is obviously the sequel to Patriots. The original novel was about the aftermath, characters dealing with the aftermath of a financial collapse, a collapse of civilization. This book sort of expands on that and sort of carries different perspectives. In the last book I read, we actually saw this one particular character. Well, one of the last ones I read, we had one U.S. military service person trying to travel across the world, out of the field, across the world, just to get home back to the United States. That's a pretty fascinating story. Here we have pretty much three main storylines. First, in Florida, we have Jake and Janelle, you know, a married couple. They own a hardware shop, and it's really interesting watching things develop, or reading about things really developing, how they really dealt with looters, the security measures they took. Also, they had a policy where they only allow a very limited amount of customers in the store at a time to sort of prevent people from running in and just grabbing stuff and getting it out. I thought that was pretty useful. They actually had armored glass they actually acquired from a bank, which was a really good idea for added security for the hardware store. They talked about bartering. You know, Janelle actually had to deal with a situation where there was a home invader, which is really creepy, really, really thrilling. She has a sister, Rayonan. Her and her husband, Peter, are missionaries. They're Christian missionaries. They're out in the Philippines. And, you know, they're in a situation where a collapse not only affects the U.S., the collapse of the U.S. dollar, but it affects a lot of other countries that are sort of tied to that. You know, militarily, countries that relied on the U.S. resources are sort of affected by that. So you have Indonesia being taken over by a radical Islamic government and threatening the countries around them, including the Philippines. They're going island to island, and they're killing people. So, you know, Peter and his wife, they have to get the heck out of their place, and they take a daring trip across the ocean, head towards Australia, and the cat and mouse games they play, well, not really games, but encounters they have are pretty thrilling. Great description of, you know, the shootouts, both in Florida. There's a situation where there's a band of looters, like thousands of people raiding certain areas in Orlando. People from Orlando, Miami, big groups raiding different towns. You know, there's definitely a sort of a sense of a city versus country thing going on in this particular storyline. But you do have racially diverse characters on both the good and the bad side of things. I thought that was pretty interesting as well. You know, one character asks, you know, how do you feel about, you know, shooting people from your own race or whatever? The response was, hey, you know, there's people, a part of my race who are fighting with me and against me. And, you know, these guys are coming here to rape and pillage and kill, you know. So it was a pretty interesting scenario watching how they really organize and really deal with that. Yeah, small town sort of dealing with how we're going to deal with these big bands of looters. Not that the book try to portray everybody from Orlando and Miami as, you know, Mad Max type of people. But anyway, those are like two of the main storylines. You know, you also have a romance blooming in Australia, and I'm watching how certain characters sort of gather resources. I didn't know that they allow people to have any guns at all in Australia, but apparently there's sort of like there's some type of bureaucracy in place. They can own certain types of guns or whatever. It's very strict. It's not like the U.S. But it's very interesting, especially if you think about going to other countries or certain countries. You're looking at this series, you know, there's a lot of characters. I should keep in mind, a lot of characters. You know, in the beginning of the book, they actually have a big list of all the characters. But the main characters, you know, Peter and his wife, her sister is actually Janelle Altmiller. You know, Altmiller, Jake and Janelle Altmiller, they're the ones in Florida. And, you know, the Jeffers, the Christian missionaries, they're the ones who are pretty much in the Philippines trying to get down to Australia to get away from the radical Islamic government. And they're concerned about the patrol boats finding them. And, you know, even the really technical stuff, like how to avoid radar and all that, they actually have this big wooden boat, and they actually went through a lot of effort to sort of come up with a certain type of diesel engine and certain types of fuels, or alternative fuels you can use for your diesel engine, even cooking oil, the strategies implemented to reduce its radar signature. The book is filled with a lot of really good details. I'm trying not to spoil it too much. I'm not saying anything about any resolutions for anything that happened there, but just to give you an idea of what's really going on in the beginning of the book and then in the middle, and we're sort of building towards, you know, expatriates. You know, at times I sort of wonder, like, would an Australian prime minister really say this in a crisis? You know, I was like, no, I don't think they would be talking about sound money at all. You know, but there's also some references to, you know, a possible UN takeover, which I thought was a little bit far-fetched, you know. But a lot of stuff I thought was more realistic was encounters with the looters and people, home invasions and stuff like that. They sort of had like a dummy government. Well, they had people within the U.S. government take over certain areas and declare themselves to be the president or whatever. And then you had the UN get involved and help them and eventually took over their position of power. That's in some of this book as well. And I thought that was pretty fascinating. But I was mostly interested in, you know, the person-to-person combat, those type of encounters, and dealing with those type of individuals. So, yeah, multiple locations, three locations, a lot of characters. But you really only need to really remember about four or five characters, really. I mean, at least that's what I was mostly focused on. The chapters are pretty short and to the point. You know, it has a nice flow to it. It doesn't get bogged down too much, you know. If I could offer a criticism, it would be that I wish the characters were developed a little bit more. It seems like there's a little bit too many characters involved, that he doesn't have quite enough time to really focus on developing certain characters, although the characters that he had for the most part are pretty likable. I don't know, I kind of wish his characters were a little bit more flawed, or at least some of them were a little bit more flawed. I think that'll make things even more interesting. And, you know, I like the fact that his characters aren't really, really stupid. You know, that's something I've always had a problem with a lot of survival stories, you know. A lot of characters make it into a post-apocalyptic situation, and they're incredibly stupid. But in these novels, they're really, really smart. But I think it'll be really interesting in his next novel, if he continues the series, if they're sort of challenged with characters that are not so smart and they're jeopardizing everybody else's safety. I think that will be a really interesting dynamic. But yes, it's very informative. Okay, things you should know about the book. It's 280 pages long. There's a glossary in the back in case you need to understand some terms, although you don't necessarily need a glossary to really move through the novel and understand what's actually going on. You also don't have to read the previous books to understand what's going on here. You don't have to read Founders or Patriots or any other ones. The story, it stands on its own. So that's something I really liked about it as well. I wouldn't say it's a Christian novel, but there's definitely some strong Christian undertones there. All the characters, well, most of the characters are Christian. And I also enjoy his ability to go to different locations seamlessly. It doesn't seem like there's a big disruption. That flows really well. So I definitely appreciate it. And, you know, I can definitely recommend this. If you're looking for a survivalist novel, go ahead. So Expatriates, if you're looking for an post-apocalyptic, post-financial collapse type of novel, this is definitely going to be right up your alley. Guys, you can pick it up October 1st, 2013. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.